The name of our first book is Lama Lama Loves to Read. Lama Lama learns at school, counting, reading, reading rules. Friends in school, there's nothing better. Lama learning all the letters. Letters make a special set. That set is called the alphabet. Lama knows the first one, 2, 3. He can say them, A, B, C, and then there's a D, and next an E, and on it goes to X, Y, Z. No two letters are the same, but every letter has a name. It can be said, it can be heard. Letters together make a word. Ant, bee, cat. Lama Lama learning words. Some he's seen and some he's heard. Some he has to memorize with his brain and with his eyes. Lama Lama knows that one. He can read it. This is fun. Lama Lama writes his name, and once again, just the same. First L, then A, M, A. What do all these letters say? Lama Lama. Something to make a present of. L-O-V-E. That spells love. Words make rhyme. Words make rhyme. Words make boots, books for story time. Words tell truth. Words tell new things. Words make songs that we can sing. Words are the very best of presents. Words together make a sentence. Lama's hooves wave in the air. Some words are hard. It's just not fair. No need to frown. No need to pout. Just do your best and sound it out. No need for crying, moaning, bleeding. Lama Lama, hooray for reading. Teacher holds the walking sign. Now it's time to make a line. How does Lama know? G and O spell go, go, go. Lots of sentences take a look. Strung together, make a book. Look inside. Oh, what glory! All these words have made a story. Lama reads so many things. Fairy princesses, pirate kings, shiny knights, and dragon fights under seas and up great heights. Back to class, and off they go, filled with all the words they know. Skipping and hopping, walking in line, Lama Lama sees a sign. And on that sign, what does he see? One S, one T, one O, one P. Stop! Lama knows that word says stop. No more skipping, no more hops. Lama reads the word out loud. Lama Lama feeling proud. School is over, the day is done. Lama had a lot of fun. Reading is fun. Who can't wait to read to Mama? You're a reader, Lama Lama. Words have magic power indeed. Ice cream. What else could a person need? Lama Lama loves to read. Our book is Cat Skidoo. Cat-skadoo! Pit-pat, pit-pat, across the floor. Mew, mew, out the door. Kittens in the garden, one cat, two. Sniffing, digging. Cat-skadoo, willy-nilly, run, run, run. Tumble, tangle, having fun. Kittens by the pool, one cat, two. Don't get wet, cats. Cat-skadoo, hurry, scurry, high and low. Scritch, scratch, scritch, up cats go. Kittens in an elm tree, one cat, two. Jump back down for cat-skadoo. Helter-skelter, roll and bounce. Skitter, scatter, leap and bounce. Kittens in the green grass, one cat, two. Here comes dog, so cat-skadoo. Hide and seek, rush, rush, rush. Stop, listen, hush, hush, hush. Someone's calling, one cat, two. Zip, skip, cat-skadoo. Scramble up steps into the house. Pit-pat, pit-pat, quiet as a mouse. Drink that milk, one cat, two. Licking, lapping, cat-skadoo. Kittens in a basket, slower, slow. Yawn and stretch and curl up so. Kittens sleeping, one cat, two. Purr and dream, cat-skadoo. The end. Our book is Little Acorn Rose Up. A little yellow acorn fell to the ground and lay there patiently without a sound. Along came White Mouse. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I will be a great big tree and my roots will make you a home. Next came Orange Squirrel. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I will be a great big tree and my trunk will keep you warm. Next came Bluebird. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I'll be a great big tree and my branches will hold your nest. Next came Gray Rabbit. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I will be a great big tree and my shade will keep you cool. Next came Brown Boar. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I will be a great big tree and my bark will scratch your back. Finally came Red Deer. Little acorn, what will you be? Someday I'll be a great big tree and my leaves will be your food. And then the little acorn started to grow. It grew bigger and wider and taller and stronger until the little acorn grew into a great big tree. And it became everything it had promised to be. the end. My Daddy is a Silly Monkey is our next book. My Daddy is a great big bear. He gets out of bed and grizzles and growls and scratches and yawns. Oh, my daddy is a naughty crocodile. He gives a toothy grin and dribbles toothpaste all over his chin. My daddy is a whirly twirly swirly octopus. He brushes my hair, sends a tux, topples a chair, spills the milk, burns the toast, ties my laces, and chuckles my lunch. My daddy is a silly monkey. He chitters and chatters and monkeys about and makes me very, very late for school. My daddy is a humongous whale. After school, he splashes and wallows and sprouts and swallows. My daddy is a jumpy kangaroo. He hippity hops, flips and flops, and flies as high as the moon. My daddy is a ravenous tiger. He mixes and mashes and gnashes his dinner until his tummy is so full, but not quite full enough, because then he is a galloping, growling monster. Tidy up, eat your dinner, get into the bath, brush your teeth, or I'm going to chase you, and catch you, and gobble you up, nom, nom, nom. At the end of the day, my daddy is too tired to play. He's not a bear, not a crocodile, not an octopus, not a whale. He's not a kangaroo, or a tiger, or a monster. He's not even a silly monkey. He is just my lovely daddy. Good night, daddy. Good night, sweetheart. The end. We are going to read, They All Saw a Cat. The cat walked through the world with its whiskers, ears, and paws. And the child saw a cat. And the dog saw a cat. And the fox saw a cat. Yes, they all saw the cat. The cat walked through the world with its whiskers, ears, and paws. And the fish saw a cat. And the mouse saw a cat. And the bee saw a cat. Yes, they all saw the cat. The cat walked through the world with its whiskers, ears, and paws. And the bird saw a cat. And the flea saw a cat. And the snake saw a cat. And the skunk saw a cat. And the worm saw a cat. And the bat saw a cat. Yes, they all saw the cat. Yes, they all saw a cat. A child and a dog and a fox and a fish and a mouse and a bee and a bird and a flea and a snake and a skunk and a worm and a bat. The cat knew them all, and they all knew the cat. and the cat walked through the world with its whiskers, ears, and paws. Then it came to the water. And imagine what it saw. The end.
Hi, my name is W. Ripto. I'm a member of the Addison Township Fire Department. I'm a lieutenant here. I've been here for 13 years. Today, we're going to talk about address signs and having your driveway properly marked and making sure that when there's an emergency, we're going to get there quickly and safely to help you with your emergency. Here are some things that we need to keep in mind when you mark your driveway and or your mailbox. In some situations, you may have to mark both your mailbox and your driveway. In situations where your driveway is across the street from your mailbox, or if you have a shared driveway where multiple houses are on your driveway, or if your driveway splits off into two or three areas, wherever it splits, you might want to have an address sign marking what side to go on, whether it's left or right or straight or however you need to do it. It's going to make our job a lot easier to get to you in that state of emergency. A few other things to keep in mind is you can have your address sign vertically or you can have it displayed horizontally. We highly suggest that you mark both sides of your address so that whenever we're coming from the north or the south or the east or the west, we can see that driveway on both sides. In our engines, in our ambulances, we have our map books. And in our map books, we have very detailed oriented pictures showing exactly where the addresses are. But having that marked, your address sign marked or your driveway marked will definitely ease us in finding your address in that state of emergency. Okay. In the map book, we have all of our hydrants marked, we have all of our streets marked, and it makes it a lot easier for us to find. So that's typically the officer's job, sitting in the officer seat. He grabs the map book and verifies with the driver exactly where we're going. And we have also a blown up section showing real quick and easy how to find your address on one sheet of paper. Instead of flipping through the book, we can go through your section and find exactly where we need to go. Okay, the address signs are $15 a piece. You can call the station at 248-628-5600 and request to have one filled out, or you can come to the station and have one filled out yourself. They're $15 a piece again, and it's definitely a good thing to have in for your driveway and for us if we ever need to get there. Thank you very much for your time today. Again, my name is W. Ripto with the Addison Township Fire Department. Thank you and have a good day.
Our book is Enough is Enough. Will had pushed Olive out of her chair more times than she could count. Enough is enough, said Olive. How do you know when enough is enough? Asked Will. I just know, said Olive. I haven't had enough, said Will. I want to play with you. I want to be alone for a while, said Olive. Being alone sounds lonely, said Will. Sounds wonderful to me, said Olive. You forgot your book, said Will. Maybe you could read it while we are both having some alone time, said Olive. Did you forget that I can't read, said Will? Just look at the picture, said Olive. I will read the book to you when I come back. I need some space. and time. It was very quiet being away from Will. Almost too quiet. "Now I'm ready," said Olive. "Me too," said Will. "Enough is enough," said Olive. And it was the end. Our book is Harry the Dirty Dog. Harry was a white dog with black spots who liked everything except getting a bath. So one day, when he heard the water running in the tub, he took the scrubbing brush and buried it in the backyard. Then he ran away from home. He played where they were fixing the street and got very dirty. He played at the railroad and got even dirtier. He played tag with the other dogs and became dirtier still. He slid down a coal chute and got the dirtiest of all. In fact, he changed from a white dog with black spots to a black dog with white spots. Although there were many other things to do, Harry began to wonder if his family thought that he had really run away. He felt tired and hungry too, so without stopping on the way, he ran back home. When Harry got to his house, he crawled through the fence and sat looking at the back door. One of the family looked out and said, "There's a strange dog in the backyard. By the way, has anyone seen Harry?" When Harry heard this, he tried very hard to show them that he was Harry. He started to do all of his old clever tricks. He flip-flopped, he flop-flipped, he rode over and played dead. He danced and he sang. He did those tricks over and over again, but everyone shook his head and said, "Oh no, it couldn't be Harry." Harry gave up and walked slowly towards the gate, but suddenly he stopped. He ran to the corner of the garden and started to dig furiously. Soon he jumped away from the hole, barking short, happy barks. He found the scrubbing brush, and carrying it in his mouth, he ran into the house. Up the stairs he dashed with the family close behind. He jumped into the tub and sat up begging with the scrubbing brush in his mouth, a trick he certainly had never done before. "This little doggy wants a bath," cried the little girl, and her father said, "Why don't you and your brother give him one?" Harry's bath was the soapiest one he had ever had. It worked like magic. As soon as the children started to scrub, they began shouting, "Mommy, Daddy, come look, come quick. It's Harry, it's Harry, it's Harry," they cried. Harry wagged his tail and was very, very happy. His family combed and brushed him lovingly, and he became once again a white dog with black spots. It was wonderful to be home. After dinner, Harry fell asleep in his favorite place, happily dreaming of how much fun it had been getting dirty. He slept so soundly, he didn't even feel the scrubbing brush he'd hidden under his pillow. The end.
President Roosevelt signed the Bill of Rights.
I've always appreciated the American Legion's...
My gratitude to the American
Thank
Legion.
Thank you all to the American Legion.
We have millions of veterans that are members of our organization. Thank you.
The American Legion, we serve America and its veterans. We pledge ourselves to our veterans, our youth, a strong national defense, and Americanism. These four pillars shape our work and what we do for America. There is power in our numbers. We're the largest organization of wartime veterans in the nation. We are 2.5 million members strong, men and women from every state in the nation and around the world. No other veterans organization wields this kind of power. We work relentlessly within our four pillars of service, and we succeed. The American Legion takes care of our fellow veterans and their families. We maintain close ties with Congress and the leaders in Washington, D.C. They respect us. They listen to us. We sponsor research and press for medical care and benefits for all veterans and active duty service members, whether they are members of the American Legion or not.
President Roosevelt signs G.I. Joe's Bill of Rights.
You've heard of the G.I. Bill of Rights, one of the most important pieces of social legislation of the 20th century. It was written and passed largely through the efforts of the American Legion. We were instrumental in the formation of what is now the Department of Veterans Affairs, to make sure our veterans get the care and benefits they are promised and deserve. The young people of our nation are our future. They benefit from exceptional programs and generous scholarships that only the American Legion offers. We provide athletic programs like American Legion Junior Shooting Sports, Legion Baseball, and educational and civics programs like the Oratorical Scholarship Contest and Boys State and Boys Nation.
As Supreme Court Justice Hugo Black stated, the quality of justice that Americans receive should not depend upon the amount of money they have.
We promote citizenship and an appreciation of government. We have all been directly involved in our nation's defense as wartime veterans. We know what policies, tools, and manpower our military needs to protect this great country. We fight to get these things done.
We're all very grateful to have the American Legion on point.
We take our case all the way to the top in Washington, D.C. to ensure that America is prepared for any threat. We are patriots through and through. We believe in our flag and all that it stands for. Our Constitution, our Pledge of Allegiance, our way of life are all fundamental to maintaining our freedom and the standing that we have as the greatest country on earth. We promote and defend these values every day in communities across the nation. These pillars represent not just what we do, but who we are. We're here to serve our fellow veterans, their families, and all of America. We are here for them. We are here for you. The American Legion asks you to join us in our mission. If you share our vision and commitment to America, visit our website at legion.org or your nearest American Legion post today.
Welcome to American Legion in Oxford for the best fish on Fridays. That's right, from noon to 8:30, you can get the best walleye in Michigan. You can get walleye, baked cod, chicken strips, baked potatoes, and more. On the hall side of the Legion, oh, hello there, friends. You can have 12 friends on a table, any one of the best military museums in Michigan. In the dining side, oh, hello again. More comfortable with many four-seat tables and a couple of five-seaters. Now, on Friday, we usually have about 400 to 500 best friends for our fish. Carry out. You bet. We have 50 to 60 carryouts at the post. We have some young fans with the birthdays and some of our best seniors at the post. Oh, yeah, waitresses, they go like a track waitress to get your food. If you have never enjoyed our secret famous walleye at the Legion, come on in every Friday from noon to 8:30 at the American Legion Post 108 on 130 East Rainier Road, Oxford.